Hi Shikha, how are you?
Hi Rakesh, I'm good. How about you?
Yeah, I'm good too. Thank you. So let us start with the mock interview. And as you know, this is a mock interview. So even if you don't know the answers of any questions, it is absolutely fine. We will be answering on your behalf. Can you tell us something about yourself?
Okay. So my name is Shikha Srivastava and I am holding a 6+ years of experience with TCS. And having started my career as a manual tester and then moved to automation with Selenium.
Mm-hmm.
So I did all the documentation process and in manual testing, I created the test case and uploaded them into a tool, ALM or Jira, whichever we are using, I have to upload them. And I have tested the API manual through Postman and automated through a UFT tool. So I did that as well.
Mm-hmm.
And recently started with Selenium with Java.
Okay.
To get a more opportunity. That's why.
Right. So you were mentioning about API testing using Postman tool. So let's say,
yes.
Given an API, what all things you will be testing via Postman? How will you automate an API? Or how will you test an API using Postman tool?
So for the Postman tool, we need the method, what method we are using. Like we have 4 methods in Postman: get, put, post, delete. So I have worked on the post method.
Mm.
So for that, I was using JSON, request JSON and response JSON. So for that, many of the things required, client ID, client secret, and grant type, and then request body. Authentication, bearer token.
Right.
So these things required for testing.
Correct. So token mechanism, you will be requiring it for the first API, basically to log in into the application.
Yes.
Now, let's say after login into the application, you have second API, one of the API, and you have to test it. Mm-hmm. So how will you test it using Postman?
We have to pass the token into second API and we have a request body. In that also we have authentication
mm-hmm.
in headers. So we pass all the required fields, which is given by the developer or any concerned person. So we fill that fields and then pass the request JSON and hit the method button, submit button above, and we get the response down at the bottom of the Postman. So we get the status as well. We note the status and response time
mm-hmm.
and match the request JSON. Yes.
Okay. Apart from this, let's say if you get this question in an interview, you can also mention about the assertions. So in Postman, you will get assertions, right? So
okay.
Yeah, while using assertions, you can mention that whether that response code of that particular API is coming 200 okay or not, or if response is considered to be, comprising of some validation message or some confirmation message. So that also you can handle it using Postman assertions. So assertions are nothing. So you have this good command on Selenium. You are aware about assertions. So similar, we have assertions checkpoints in Postman as well. So when you have any API which you have to test, so you can use assertions over there.
Okay.
Right. Now, how many test cases do you automate every day?
It depends basically the complexity of the test use case.
Mm-hmm.
So it depends. Sometimes it will take one test case to a whole day, or sometimes I can automate 4 to 5 test cases in a day. So it depends upon the complexity of the application.
Okay. And how do you trigger your automation, or how do you run your automation?
I'm running through ALM,
mm-hmm.
but basically I have developed the AI pipeline in Azure DevOps.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So I have developed that, but still we are running from ALM.
Mm-hmm.
So in ALM we have option the run test.
Mm-hmm.
So we can run from there, and I sequentially arrange the test cases in the test lab, and then I learned. So I will learn. So it will run automatically in a sequence manner.
Okay. Can you tell me about the pipeline that you have created in the Azure DevOps? Which are the various
yes.
in the pipeline, right from start to the end?
Okay, so we need Git repository where we have stored the code and the test files. So we need Git repository for the connection and pipeline. In there, I have pipe. There's a tab called pipeline.
Okay.
In there, I have to create the create pipeline and then associate my Git repository project there. We get the box there.
Mm-hmm.
And when we create the we create the repository, and then we move to the part in which machine we want to trigger.
Okay.
And JUnit is means JUnit is automatically selected, and we use that only.
Mm-hmm.
And then we made a select the Maven project.
Mm-hmm.
And then we move to save and queue.
Mm-hmm.
So basically we have 4 to 5 points. I'm not remembering that. We have to enter that. And when we edit that pipeline, we have trigger option there, where we can schedule our test case and log. We can create our logs there. Means we can click on the checkbox, and in this manner I have created.
Mm-hmm. Right. So basically, once the entire suite will run end to end, you will be sending a sort of automation reports to the stakeholders or to the teams who are actually working on those projects, right?
Right.
Right. So that is also a part of your pipeline itself.
Yeah.
Hmm?
But yes, it is a pipeline. It is a part of my pipeline, but still it is not fully accomplished.
Mm-hmm. Okay. No issues. It is not fully accomplished, but these are a few of the very key points. Let's say the automation is running, but it is very important that at the end of the day, the build analysis or whether the build is stable or not, that kind of report should go to the testing team or development team. And at the end, you might have been integrating it with Jira or with whichever defect management tool that you are working on to make sure that if any tests are failing, yeah, so you will be logging the defect in that particular tool itself, right? So no manual process at all. Right. So whenever you give this answer, you can complete this answer with this particular 2 points. These are very important about the automation report and about the logging of the defects in the defect management. Right. So this is very good thing that you have got an opportunity to implement this kind of or to do implementation of Azure DevOps. You have created pipeline also, right? By yourself.
Yes.
This is good. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now you were mentioning something about Maven, right? So have you?
I want to encounter it. I am learning Maven. I've started not working. So my previous project I have learned not through Maven and all, but I'm still not working.
Okay, so you have learned Maven and now you are trying to put it, do hands-on experience on Maven.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And how do you find XPath?
We have syntax to find the XPath, like double slash
mm-hmm.
tag name within right. a square bracket attribute and equal to, in single slash we have value. And we close the bracket. When we inspect the element in the web page, we have to press Control F to write this syntax. Mm-hmm. And we have one more if we did not find unique value in the XPath, so we have to find by the index basis. So we close the XPath in a circular bracket, and then we give the index value in its square bracket.
Correct. This is how you find the XPath manually, generally by inspecting element in Google Chrome browser and all this. Do you use
Yes.
any tool or any plugin extension to find XPath?
No, till now I did not use. But I know there are some tools and plugins are available in the market.
Right. So you can use those tools as well, like selectors hub is there. And other many extensions are there that are very helpful to find XPath. And they'll give you a reliable XPath as well. Right?
Okay.
Now, can you tell me about the folder structure or the project structure and give me a brief about the automation framework that you are working on?
Like folder structure, I did not understand which automation framework. If I talk about, I recently start with TestNG. So there are a notation, test, before shoot, after shoot. These are the things I have started with.
Okay.
Yeah, annotations are there.
Mm-hmm.
And we select the, we set the priority as well.
Mm-hmm.
I have checked the, means I got one question for the TestNG priority well. So I have done practical hands-on on this. So when we set the zero priority or one or negative priority, and did not send the priority. So which will test case run first? So I am doing on hands-on on this.
Right. So those are a few of the common interview questions you will get in the interview.
Yes.
Yeah. Apart from that, what all things are there in your automation framework?
Excel sheet is there. We are calling from data from the Excel, which is Excel. Double SF book, workbook from this and from this syntax.
Mm-hmm.
And we used to take the screenshot as well, which are the failed test cases.
Okay.
So I take screenshot folder is there. And sorry, I only remembering these things.
No issues. That is absolutely fine. See, in an interview, you will get this question about your automation framework. So you can start by explaining about the programming language that you have used in the automation framework. Let's say many people are using Selenium with Java. Many people are using Selenium with Python. Some people are using C#. Some people are using .NET. So you can explain about the you can start about the programming language. Then you are mentioning about TestNG, so that is also good. Then apart from that, you would have created a Maven project, basically. There would be a pom.xml in which you would be listing out the various dependencies. Okay.
Yes.
As you were mentioning about the Excel file, so I think it's more kind of a data-driven framework. So directly you can tell it's a data-driven framework where the data is taking from the Excel file. And basically you would be using Apache POI. For that,
yes, Apache POI.
Right.
Yes,
and there will be interfaces which you would be using to call the data from one particular cell or from rows in an Excel file, and then
yes,
you can come to the output folder. In the output folder, basically, if you are using the default report that is generated by TestNG, so it would be generated in the output folder of the directory, and if it's not been used, then you would have been using extend report or library report. So there are many options. Again, customizable report options are also there, which you can use. Okay. Now, if you are implementing a page object model framework, then you can tell about the pages that you have created. Let's say if you are, okay. So we'll come to that as well. So this is how you can explain your automation framework in the brief. And that was a good point that you added about the screenshots, that you are capturing the screenshots whenever it is getting failed, right? Now, apart from this, you can also add or work on basically in Jira or in test management tool, you would have written test cases. So over there, you would have created test cycles, which would be having all the test cases within them, those cycles. So basically, when your automation runs, you are also logging into the Jira and you are making the test case as pass or fail depending on the result of the automation. So that is also one of the things that you can add into your framework, and then you can tell in an interview.
Okay.
Okay, now consider an application. Let's say if it's a Gmail based application. Okay, you have login page. You will log in into the Gmail using username, password, and then you will be having the inbox, Gmail inbox, where all your mails will be coming. Okay, now I want you to automate this particular functionality. Okay, using page object model. So how will you automate it, or how will you implement page object model in this for this automation?
For page object model, I guess we have a first page of the Gmail where we have to put our credentials. So I will create for that credential and login button should be there. So we have two or three test cases there itself. First, login the application through automation. And invalid credential, we have to use that itself. And third is blank. So in one page, we have three test cases. So we'll implement that and we'll create object repository for that, for the same. And if we come, when it is login successfully, so the alert messages will come that it is login successfully. So for that, I have to create another folder, another page for the these alert messages, to store the these alert messages. And if I talk about inbox, so we have many things in inbox page.
Right. Inbox draft is there. Sent items is there.
Sent.
Archives.
Attachment.
Attachments is there.
Recycle bin is there. So for that, inbox is fine for that. The messages which are coming,
right,
I can store in a one object repository in one page. But for the rest of the things, it might take long. Like, yes, sorry, I know how many days.
Please. Yeah, no issues. That is absolutely fine. Let's say if you are, asked in an interview about how will you automate this particular web application or this particular software using page object model, what you can start up with is a configuration file. Basically, you can add. You are mentioning about username and password, right? So these things are again have to be kept dynamic. Let's say today, for automation purpose, you are using, for example, some username and password. Tomorrow, you'll have to run for other username and password. So these things you'll have to keep dynamic. So you can put this in the one of the text file, or you can say XML file, and then you are reading data from this particular file. So that thing you can do. Then you can tell
we
about...
Can, sorry, yeah, we can put... We can put these things in a property file as well, I guess.
Correct. Yeah, configuration file slash property file, whichever you can use. That is one and the same thing. Then second thing comes about the, it's a page object model. So you will be creating objects, as you were mentioning, in the repository. So those are the various pages that you will be keeping. So one page will be completely of the login based objects. One page will be after logging in, whichever the Gmails that we have, the Gmail UI. Based on that, you'll be creating one page. The another folder structure would be of the test, in which you will be mentioning all your tests. So basically, using those objects, using those XPath of the elements, you will be creating test. So in that test, again, you can create first test as of login itself. Second test, you can create of sending the email. Third test, you can create of retrieving the email or reading the email, whichever there are in the Gmail inbox, right? So those things you can explain. And over here, for now, you can keep like testng only as the default report, right? So this is how you can explain about the page object things that can be asked to you. Okay. Now, okay. Let's say if it's an banking based application that you are supposed to do a testing, and there is a junior person who is there a part of your team itself. He is a team member along with you. He has written few of the test cases to test particular banking based applications. Okay. Now, while reviewing the test cases, what all parameters or what all things you will validate whether he or she has included or not in their test cases?
In banking, we can take the example of account creation.
Mm-hmm.
So while he or she is taking care of the test cases,
mm-hmm.
or the scripts, so I need to confirm many of the things that we have the spelling errors in the in the creation of account.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to check that it is correct or not.
Mm-hmm.
And banking account creation. Mm-hmm. Nominee name should be there.
Okay.
All the mandatory checks should be filled correctly.
Mm-hmm.
And we cannot find it is correct or not, because it is once the user gave this manually, and we have to enter it in that manner, we have to check. So we can means I can validate these parameters, and he or she should be able to log in successfully.
Mm-hmm.
I guess these are the test case I am telling you.
Right. So these are the test scenarios that you are telling. The question is about, let's say he or she has already written the test cases. Now you are supposed to review their test cases and, you know, give a green signal that yes, this functionality can be tested by this set of test cases. So what all things you will check or you will validate whether they are there in as a part of test cases that has been written or not? I'll give you a hint.
I'll check.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Please go ahead. Yeah.
Before creation of the test case, we prepare the test scenarios. Mm-hmm. So I'll match they have covered all the test scenarios and the test cases or not.
Mm-hmm. Test scenarios with respect and, to requirement documents or BRD, FRD.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right.
And that means the language prerequisite should be correct.
Mm-hmm.
That it should be simply understandable, because if he or she or any of the member leaves the team, mm-hmm. So new person come in and he can easily understand those test cases.
Correct.
Expected and actual result should be captured, mm-hmm. very in a good manner,
mm-hmm.
and priority of the test case, that is high priority or low, medium, and risk. So we have to check the proving step that he has mentioned or not.
Mm-hmm.
So in that manner I can validate the things, and then this is called peer review before mm-hmm. sending yeah, to yeah. the approval.
Correct.
Green signal
peer review. Yeah.
So I'll do that, and if any correction required, I'll or we have like if we are using Jira or Azure DevOps, we have created tasks. So if any difficulty or any means any line missing, anything is missing, I have found, I need to capture in the tool itself by using comment box, so that he can correct them, and then we can again review, and then I can give the green signal.
Got it. Any other thing that you feel?
If we talk about in automation in no, no. this case.
No, no, not from automation perspective, just from manual testing perspective.
Manual test.
Mm-hmm.
So, uh, We can check that any field is not missing. Means basically, if any field is missing, the test case won't upload from the Excel to the ALM. I'm using Excel, and while manually creating the test cases, I have used Jira as well.
Okay.
So in Jira, I did not use Excel to write the test cases. I used only the structure folder, which was mentioned in Jira.
Okay.
And yeah, if any field is missing in ALM, so it won't upload the test case. Mm. It will give the red error or validation error while uploading the test cases. Mm-hmm. So these things we can validate.
Right, right. Okay.
And talk about the things. And the test...
Mm-hmm.
I'm not getting not much, only these things.
No issues. Apart from this, you can add about test data as well. Let's say if it's a banking based application and we have to create an account, so we will be uploading the images of few of the required documents like Aadhaar card, PAN card is there. So if we have to upload those images, so those can be in the JPG, PNG format, right? So those kind of documentation, so whatever test data is required, let's say the test data holds a very important, plays a very vital role in test cases, right? So you can make sure that they have added sufficient test data to test that particular scenario, okay? If it's an attachment, then all types of files, whichever extension it would support and to what size it is allowing us to upload, right? Those things we will be keeping mentioning in the test data. Then second thing is about the happy path and the negative testing as well. Let's say the application is working absolutely fine with the positive flow of the application. But what about the negative testing? Right. So negative test cases should also be included in the testing, this particular test cases. Okay. So even if they have not added them and you are reviewing their test cases, so make sure that those test cases are also included in their test set. Those are there. So two things, test data as well as happy path and negative testing as well, you'll have to include.
Okay.
Now, what do you mean by test closure report?
A test closure is report is basically we send at the last stage mm-hmm. of this cycle. So in which we mentioned the in this release, we have found these many bugs. And these many fixes has been done.
Mm-hmm.
We right. would mention that.
Mm-hmm.
And if we found any bug, like if we are sending the application to the production with mm-hmm. known bugs, so mm-hmm. we have to mention that as well, that these bugs are existing, we will fix in the next release.
Mm-hmm.
So right. and that should logged in a like that should be logged in a Jira tool as well, Jira or whatever tool we are using. And the summary of the summary like the scenario, the acceptance criteria that this is working fine. So I guess. Yeah, I have submitted the test closure report only these points of mentioning these points. And we have some more things which is related to the versions related and the build related, releases related. And we have to sign that document as well.
Okay, great. This looks good. Okay, now let's say you are... you have to test a particular video based application. Let's say you are testing a YouTube video. Okay. Now, what all test scenarios that you will be including in your testing? Can you tell me the high level test scenarios for testing a video based or videos, YouTube videos, simple YouTube videos?
So I've tried to automate the YouTube video.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm unable to play through Selenium with Java.
Yeah, yeah.
I
automation.
It is not separate.
Right. Automation is fine. let's say if it's a manual testing project completely. Okay.
Okay.
Now you have
so,
to particular. Yeah. So what would be the high level test scenarios?
Higher level test scenarios is like user should able to launch the URL. This is the first test scenario. And in search box, when it is searching anything, it should be searchable. And yes, if we talk about if anybody is searching with numbers, like we have to search with text or numbers. We can search from anything. So if he has tried from the numbers or alphanumeric in a text box, so what he get the result, we have to add that test case as well. And it should come the a pop-up is coming like skip trial or trial trial version, so this is coming or not. And we will we will play the video. The video we are searching, it's playing or not, and it is in which format, pixel is getting the image while playing the video, the image is getting distorted or video is getting distorted or not. And means we run the video, we start the video, it should ask for the subscription button, description box, comment box, bell icon. So these things we need to write in a test scenarios, and user would able to comment the in a comment section if he or she able to comment or not. And we likes, like button and dislike button is there. He or should be the user should be able to click or not. And when we search the video, suppose I have searched for the automation, so the list of auto suggestion list is coming in the down, so that list should become. And these are the happy watch scenarios. If I talk about negative testing, we can test, we can put the special characters in the search box and try to search that it is searching or not. And yes, we have one more quality when we we have to select its HD quality value. It's 240p and quality of the, and we have the to video to like faster by 0.25 second or 1.25. These things should be covered in this YouTube application.
Correct. Besides this, let's say if you are watching it from the mobile, so automatically other test scenarios will come into the picture. Let's say you are watching it by keeping your mobile in the vertical mode, or you're watching it by keeping the mobile in the auto rotate mode. And the moment you are watching it or one of the video on in the mobile, and you are getting a call, or you're getting a message, or you're getting a WhatsApp call, or you're getting a WhatsApp video call, then what is the response of the application? Or what happens to that particular video? Is it getting paused or is it getting resumed? And when you receive some particular call and then again you continue watching that video, so has it moved ahead or has it paused by the duration when you are receiving the call? So those kind of mobile testing scenarios you can also add. And then let's say if that particular video URL has been embedded in any particular website, and then you are opening it in some particular browser, that particular website, then are you able to launch that particular video from that web link? So this is also one of the thing. And let's say if you have mentioned that particular YouTube URL in any of the social media platforms like LinkedIn, Facebook, then you are just scrolling and over there the video should get started. You know, somehow it starts and you are able to watch that by the time, and then the moment you scroll down, so it is not playing at all. So those things you can add. Okay, so what is the difference between QA and QC?
QA is quality analyst and QC is quality control.
Yeah, QA is quality assurance.
Quality assurance. Yeah, quality assurance.
Mm-hmm.
So QC, like HPLM is a QC tool,
mm-hmm.
where we capturing all the details related to the testing, quality assurance. And quality assurance is like we have to QA has to test the quality of the product or application, which whatever he or she is testing.
Mm-hmm.
So give the assurance while doing the positive, negative, and entire ad hoc testing using this. So, and in quality control, we manage all the documentation that that is done by quality assurance team. So mm-hmm. I know only these points.
Okay, no issues. So you can add some more points. You know, the significance of having QA is to prevent the defect, to make sure that the defect is not getting created, while QC is to identify the defects and improve the defects, right? For QC, only testing team, or you can take only software testers would be taking a part in the QC. But for QA, all the team members are responsible for QA. Okay. You can give an example of verification with respect to quality assurance, and you can give an example of validation with respect to quality control. Okay. So basically, quality control is all about validation. So you can tell about dynamic testing, while QA is all about, you know, kind of static testing you can mention. Okay. So those are things. Okay. Now, what is the difference between array list and vector?
Array list is a list of characters. And factors, I don't know about factors.
Okay. Yeah, please go ahead. You want to give a try?
Factors, I really don't cross with factors. So I don't know what exactly it is.
Okay. Basically, you know, array list, you can tell it's not synchronized, but vector is actually synchronized. And array list is not thread safe, as it is not synchronized basically. While vector list is more of a thread safe kind of thing. And vectors is kind of a legacy class, while array list is not a legacy class. One more question that you can get, you know, around this is, what is the difference between array list and linked list? Right. Are you aware about linked list?
I've just gone through,
mm-hmm.
but I don't remember.
Okay, no issues. So this will be an open question to the viewers of this video. What is the difference between array list and linked list? Okay, now what do you know about Jenkins?
Jenkins is the reporting tool where we can trigger our jobs, create the builds, and send the jobs to the production.
Mm-hmm.
We have the builds and releases there. Mm-hmm. So we are sending the when we send the build to the production, we use Jenkins.
Mm-hmm.
And we can trigger our jobs there, schedule our jobs there itself.
Mm-hmm. So you can mention and that CI/CD tool, continuous integration deployment tool, right?
Right, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So in an interview, if you get this question, what is Jenkins? So it's no longer a reporting tool, but it's actually a CI/CD tool. It will take the code, the recent code from the repository. It would create a machine on the fly, It would dump all the code, the development code and the automation code. It will trigger the automation. It will generate a report as well. Right? So these all things are done by Jenkins basically. Right? And you have worked on the Azure DevOps, right? Similar kind of to this Jenkins.
Yes, I have worked in a previous project. It's 4 years back.
Oh, okay. Nice. Okay, Shikha, I am done with the interview. Do you have any questions for me?
Yes, so I want to know, as I have, as this interview is very helpful. I get to know about where I am lacking, but still about to know these in this market, whatever going on and where I need to improve myself. I need to know these things.
Sure.